afternoon. My name is, of course, Dr. Camille Samuel, and it is my absolute pleasure to guide you through these virtual proceedings. We will now have the national anthem, followed by the invocation. We thank you for this opportunity to join virtually with our students and their families in their homes, wherever they may be, in Trinidad and Tobago or any other parts of the world, celebrating the achievements of our 2020 graduating class. We thank you, God, for the blessing of the successful completion of this phase of their journey, and pray that your favor and grace will be with them and their loved ones as they embark upon the next chapter of their lives. Almighty Creator, we pray that your hand of protection continues to be upon them and that you will light their paths along their journey through life. We thank you, Lord, for our beloved college, COSTAATT, and for all members of the board, management, faculty, staff, and students, and for everyone gathered at home to participate in this graduation ceremony, and even those who could not join. We ask that you bless these proceedings, Lord, and that you keep us all safe from this global pandemic as you give your angels charge over us, so that we will all continue to live our lives and discharge our duties safely. These things we pray. At this time, it is truly my pleasure to introduce you to our President, Dr. Gillian Paul, to preside over the rest of the afternoon's proceedings. Dr. Paul.
Dr. The Honorable Nyan Gatsby Dolly, Minister of Education. Dr. Wayne A.I. Frederick, President of Howard University, and this afternoon's keynote speaker. Dr. Rita Pemberton, Chairman of the COSTAATT Board of Trustees and other board members. Vice Presidents, Deans, Chairs, Program Coordinators, faculty staff, graduands, students, family, and friends who are watching this afternoon's proceedings, I welcome you to the graduation ceremony 2020. The theme of the 2020 graduation ceremony, The Will to Rise, offers us an opportunity for reflection, affirmation, and for taking a firm position on what we will require to meet the future fearlessly and with our continued determination to succeed. As the National Community College of Trinidad and Tobago, this beautiful, multicultural, multiracial, multi-ethnic twin island state, it should come as no surprise that our student body is very diverse. We draw students from every corner of the nation. They are diverse in beliefs, diverse in age, diverse in goals and aspirations, and we embrace and celebrate that diversity. But there are few things that unite the student body in spite of their diversity. Certainly, one is the widely held and universal dislike of group work. Secondly, I believe the thing that unites the student body most is the will to rise. For many of our students, families, friends, even teachers did not believe that the dream of college pertained to them. They came from circumstances where they'd be first generation college goers. They were grappling with challenges, academic, financial, familial, professional, and nobody saw college and the earning of the degree on the horizon. But one morning they woke up and they took the decision, I will rise. I am going to be better. I am going to achieve. I am going to set myself the goal of earning a degree, and I am going to achieve that goal. And we are here this afternoon to celebrate with all our graduates who took that decision, made the determination, embraced the will to rise, and are here now to celebrate the achievement. Now, many in the academic enterprise will tell you that I have been quite resolute over the last few years in maintaining that the COSTAATT graduation should be about the students and not about the college. And that is particularly so because the circumstances in which we have grown have not afforded us many spaces where the student body can come together in large numbers to recognize each other, to celebrate each other, and to feel as one student body. In point of fact, graduation is really the only event in the life of the college where we have so many students assembled at one point. But I want to beg your indulgence to depart from my own prescription to talk a little bit about the college, because I believe that there are intense similarities between COSTAATT and our students. Many of you here today would not be aware of the very intense struggle and long struggle it took to establish COSTAATT. Although the college was established in 2000, in fact, we had been fighting for 10 years to convince many different administrations that Trinidad and Tobago needed a college that was dedicated for the type of students that you represent. And we never gave up, and we persisted, and we were tenacious, resourceful, resilient. Many of the attributes that you know that you have had to acquire and display and demonstrate over and over again to get to this point where you are now graduating with your degree. When I recall the small planning office that we had on Sackville Street, the team that worked to establish COSTAATT, and I look around today and recognize that we are in our purpose-built campus, celebrating our first virtual graduation. It's a tangible demonstration of what the will to rise and the will to succeed and the resourcefulness and the determination can produce. And so I make bold to claim that we are bonded by the will to rise. You and the college, we are the COSTAATT family. We share the same DNA. We don't know what the future will bring. The pandemic, everyone has said, will transform higher education permanently. We will never go back to the old ways. But I am making bold and confidently saying, whatever that new future looks like for you personally, for you and your family, for COSTAATT, I know, because I have seen the evidence, that the will to rise will be the hallmark of your future. I welcome you and enjoy this afternoon's proceedings. I'm really very happy tonight to be able to introduce the Honorable Nyan Gatsby Dolly, Minister of Education, who is no stranger to COSTAATT, and who may, in fact, have taught some of this afternoon's graduates. Dr. Gatsby Dolly, we welcome you.
During this evening's graduation ceremony, Dr. Jillian Paul, President of COSTAATT, Dr. Wayne Frederick, President of Howard University, Vice Presidents, Deans, Directors and Department Chairs, faculty and staff of COSTAATT, our honored guests, members of the graduating class of 2020, parents, relatives, friends, other members of the viewing audience, ladies and gentlemen. The graduating class of 2020. I am sure that for many of you, the idea of being here at this time last year seemed impossible. We were in the height of a global pandemic, and the uncertainty of the future seeped into every aspect of our lives. Even now, we are still feeling the effects. Yet, here we are today. Of course, we're doing things a little differently from how we did it before. By having this virtual ceremony, however, as Trinagonians, we know one thing, that we will always find a way. Your graduation today is testimony to your hard work, your resilience, your support systems at home and at the college, which has done human service to ensure that this particular cohort was able to make it to their graduation. Today, the selected theme emphasizes what I believe every citizen of our country embodied over the past year, the will to rise. As I saw the theme, it immediately reminded me about a quote that I have heard. Your current situation is not your final destination. The best is yet to come. I'm sure you've heard this quote too. And this is what I'd like you to take away from today's proceedings. I want to congratulate each one of you for your purposeful and passionate push to be here today. It could not have been an easy route, but if it were easy, what stories would we tell? You have been able to make it to this point, to complete this level of education when so many countries globally are still trying to bring back their education systems, reeling from the effects of COVID-19. You have risen, and your will to rise beyond circumstance is an inspirational one. Do not hold back on sharing your experience with those who are aspiring to walk in your shoes. You never know who may be listening, and you never know who you may inspire. As you reflect on the hardships that 2020 would have inflicted and the challenges that you would have overcome to get to this point, I am sure that you realize that you are stronger than you thought, and I'm sure that you realize that compared to when this year began, you are better than you thought. But the best is yet to come. I have been sharing with audiences over the past year that we are a resilient people, and today re-emphasizes that for me. This is not only applicable to the graduates here, but to the leadership of the College of Science, Technology, and Applied Arts of Trinidad and Tobago. And of course, you know, COSTAATT always holds a very special place in my heart. So allow me this opportunity to congratulate the board and the president and the staff, the administration of COSTAATT for making and keeping education a priority in challenging times. At the Ministry of Education, we can only do so much to ensure that financing and policy are well managed, but it is you, the people on the ground, the foot soldiers, who ensure that this country's future is preserved through the delivery of quality education. As I close, allow me to reiterate to the graduating class of 2020, take every lesson that you have learned. Take everything that the college has equipped you with in this challenging time and use it as you transition to your next phase, be it academic or otherwise. Know that you are well prepared for whatever may come your way. You have proven that you have the will to rise. I add to that today that your best days are yet to come. Be bold, be fearless, and continue to be resilient. Allow me to close with the words of a popular Yolanda Adams song. That song is titled, Still I Rise. Shattered, but I'm not broken. Wounded, but time will heal. Heavy the load, the cross I bear. Lonely the road I trod, I dare. Shaken, but here I stand. Weary, still I press on. Long are the nights, the tears I cry. Dark are the days, no sun in the sky. Yet still I rise, never to give up. Never to give in against all odds. Yet still I rise, high above the clouds. At times I feel low, yet still I rise. Congratulations to the risen, to the graduates of 2020.
With great pleasure and pride, I extend sincere congratulations to the graduating class of 2020 on behalf of the 7th Board of Trustees of COSTAATT. Although this first virtual graduation ceremony has not been the college's tradition, it still represents the celebration of your experience and the opportunity to share the event with a wide range of supportive family and friends. This evening ceremony has been long in the making, disrupted, as we all know, by the COVID-19 pandemic, which also radically transformed the teaching and learning experience for students and faculty alike. Overcoming the challenges which you, our students, resolutely faced to successfully complete your studies under very new and sometimes difficult conditions, it is testimony to your tenacity, resilience, and ability to adapt to new circumstances. These qualities will serve you in good stead as you leave the college to face uncertainty in the labor market or new demands and performance expectations in your workplace. Trinidad and Tobago continues to grapple with the changes wrought by the pandemic on the economic fortunes of our twin island state. The country would need a new type of workforce if it is to emerge from this period stronger and better positioned to thrive and grow in the post-pandemic era. Learning is the hill we must climb. And as Poet Laureate Amanda Gorman has advised, we must grieve and grow, hurt and hope, get tired and keep trying. Innovation, excellence and efficiency will be key to our capacity as a people to take advantage of the opportunities that the pandemic has created in forcing all nations to stop and rethink the ways in which we work and live. I know you are anxious to celebrate the award for which you have labored so hard, but I wish to remind you that this is the first step in today's world in which continuous learning is mandatory. As Calypsonian Chris Tambu Herbert said, the journey now starts. Please take heed of the wise words of Nelson Mandela: after climbing the great hill, one only finds there are many more hills to climb. The board exhorts you to keep on rising with your eyes on the stars, your wings adjusted to the wind, and your feet remain grounded to the realities around you. To quote Mandela again, you will find the greatest glory not in never falling, but rising when you fall. This evening, over 850 students will graduate
in a wide range of disciplines and will be seeking employment or career advancement in critical sectors of our economy. I am confident that with the new skills and competencies that you would have acquired in transitioning into the online environment, you will make your mark in your chosen occupation. I speak here not only of technological skills, but also of important workplace competencies such as time management and multitasking. We hope too that your capacity for empathy has been expanded as the pandemic highlighted the many common experiences that we share as human beings confronted with the same risks and responsibilities despite our differences. I also want to take this opportunity to commend our faculty and staff who ably rose to the challenge to convert our programs and administrative services to facilitate online delivery so you could continue to safely pursue studies. Many of our faculty and staff are also parents or guardians who had to take on additional childcare responsibilities while participating in numerous training sessions and course redesign activities. They did so willingly and, by most reports, with considerable success. Our well-established commitment to student-centeredness at COSTAATT demanded nothing less. So, let this be your guiding mantra. Be relevant and responsive to national needs. Be impactful with innovation and creativity, and serve the community and nation with efficiency. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, I encourage you, our graduates and faculty and staff of the college, not to lose the important lessons of the pandemic, but rather to harness and utilize your education and training as your foundation for further growth and development. The board wishes you blessings as you pursue your dreams and soar on the wings of continued success in all your endeavors.
Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to introduce today's keynote speaker, Dr. Wayne Frederick. Dr. Wayne A.I. Frederick was appointed the 17th president of Howard University in 2014. He previously served as provost and chief academic officer. Most recently, the Howard University Board of Trustees selected Dr. Frederick to serve as the Distinguished Charles R. Drew Professor of Surgery. Dr. Frederick has advanced Howard University's commitment to student opportunity, academic innovation, public service, and fiscal stability. He has overseen a series of reform efforts, including the expansion of academic offerings, establishing innovative programs to support student success, and the modernization of university facilities. Dr. Frederick received his Bachelor of Science and Medical degree from Howard University. Following his postdoctoral research and surgical oncology fellowships at the University of Texas MD Anderson Cancer Center, Dr. Frederick began his academic career as Associate Director of the Cancer Center at the University of Connecticut. Upon his return to Howard University, his academic positions included Associate Dean in the College of Medicine, Division Chief in the Department of Surgery, Director of the Cancer Center, and Deputy Provost for Health Sciences. He also earned a Master of Business Administration from Howard University School of Business in 2011. Dr. Frederick is the author of numerous peer-reviewed articles, book chapters, abstracts, and editorials, and is a widely recognized expert on disparities in healthcare and medical education. His medical research focuses on narrowing racial, ethnic, and gender disparities in cancer care outcomes, especially pertaining to gastrointestinal cancers. Dr. Frederick was honored with the Distinguished Alumnus Award from the University of Texas MD Anderson Cancer Center. He currently serves on the Board of Directors for the Federal Reserve Bank of Richmond, the U.S. Chamber of Commerce, and Humana Incorporated. He's a member of surgical and medical associations, including the American Surgical Association and the American College of Surgeons. In 2017, he was named Washingtonian of the Year by Washingtonian Magazine, and in 2015 was named Male President of the Year by HBCU Digest. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Wade Frederick.
Welcome to the class of 2020 and to all of your friends and family members who are gathered virtually to celebrate you today. Greetings. My name is Wayne A.I. Frederick. I'm the president of Howard University and the Charles R. Drew Professor of Surgery at Howard University Hospital. As a Trinidadian myself, it is my distinct honor to address you all as we celebrate a significant milestone in the academic careers and the lives of today's graduates from the College of Science, Technology, and Applied Arts of Trinidad and Tobago. Graduation is always worthy of celebration, but for students like today's class of 2020, who endured the trials and tribulations of the coronavirus pandemic and still managed to complete their education, a graduation is more than just a milestone. In the diploma that you are all earning today, you're acquiring a badge of honor. This piece of paper is a testament to what you are capable of and a reminder of what you are working for. As the president of Howard University, I have witnessed the many faces of struggle and suffering during this past year. Many of my students already come from limited means and under-resourced communities, and the pandemic exacerbated their present-day challenges at a time when they most needed to focus on their futures. Many of our students confronted food and housing insecurity. They grappled with poor internet connections or insufficient technological devices. They dealt with devastating personal losses among their family and friends and communities. We should all strive to create a world where no one has to suffer the way the pandemic caused so many to. But amidst the inspiring examples of endurance and resilience that rose up to counter the hardship of the past year, we can see the promise of a better world coming closer and closer to our grasp. All we have to do is reach out and seize it. I know that many students at the College of Science, Technology, and Applied Arts of Trinidad and Tobago have struggled in similar ways to my Howard students. When a crisis strikes and our personal situations become unstable, our priorities can shift. Certain responsibilities like homework and classes can seem like distractions. Grades and diplomas can feel intangible and inconsequential. To persevere under these conditions that you all experience necessitates more than personal will and ambition. It actually requires a mission. I hope that your education has awakened within you a purpose that will carry you forward in life. Higher education is certainly an opportunity for us to better ourselves and to plan for our futures. But most importantly, it is a time where we can begin to hear our personal calling, when we can begin to discern an answer to one of life's most important questions. What is the difference that I am supposed to make in this world? To fulfill your purpose in life, you need a certain base of knowledge and set of skills that would empower you to generate change in your communities and societies and in our world at large. That calling is what drove you to complete your studies under such trying circumstances and will sustain you when you encounter obstacles as you go out into the world armed with your education. Even as the world appears poised to put the coronavirus pandemic behind us, we know that many of the inequities and injustices this latest crisis helped expose will continue to exist. But fortunately, it appears that our world is on the brink of transformation. COVID-19 pandemic has gripped the entirety of the planet, binding us in common struggle and common purpose. Collectively, we must determine what a post-pandemic normal looks like. Together, we have to decide what values and principles will dictate our world's long-term future. As one, we will elevate the leaders who have the vision and integrity needed to usher forth greater prosperity for all. As students of science and technology and other critical subject areas, our world is going to look to you. Today's graduates, your charge is simple: to change the world, to see the world as it is, and use your skill and passion to make it better. You are positioned to translate knowledge into action, to ensure that what we learn as a human race has practical application for the greater good of all mankind. It is a difficult task, I know, but I have every confidence that you are equal to it. As the African proverb says, however long the night, the dawn will break. Despite the length and devastation of the pandemic, we will get past it. And when the morning sun casts down its light, the new world will be one that you have created. The resilience and grit you all demonstrated to continue your education during the pandemic is the same inner characteristics that compelled you to matriculate to the College of Science, Technology, and Applied Arts of Trinidad and Tobago in the first place. You all pursued higher education, not because it was expected, but because you felt it to be important. Prior to coming to Howard, many of our students are overlooked and underestimated. Perhaps no one expects them to attend an elite institution of higher education, or maybe no one expects them to go to college at all. But Howard University is committed to giving opportunity to those with promise, especially when they can't get a chance to demonstrate their potential anyplace else. In many ways, that ethos is what brought me from Trinidad and Tobago when I grew up to Howard University. And it is and has continued to motivate me to spend so much of my adult life and professional career right here on Howard University's campus. At the age of 3, my grandmother told me that I had sickle cell anemia, a disease we discovered I had as a result of newly imposed mandatory screenings in Trinidad and Tobago. She patiently described the details of my disease in a way that even a young child could try to understand. There was a problem with my blood. It would cause me pain, and I would have this condition my entire life, however long it might be. My grandmother conveyed this information not to scare me, but to prepare me. She wanted me to be aware of and informed about my disease so I could fight it. She wanted me to acknowledge and be honest about my condition, not to defeat me, but to inspire hope so I could combat an enemy that I understood. In the same moment that she explained my life's biggest struggle, she also instilled in me the confidence to overcome it. As a child, I remember being surrounded by books. My family placed particular importance on of acquiring an education and using it to do good. My father was a police officer, my mother was a nurse. My grandfather was a school teacher who would become a lawyer later on in life. So I was taught very early on that with a proper education, there was nothing beyond my reach. With the power of knowledge, I would be able to advocate for myself, and I was expected to advocate on behalf of others. Motivated by my ambitions to become a physician and my sickle cell disease, I arrived at Howard University in 1988. I enrolled in Howard's bachelor's and MD combined dual program and graduated at the age of 22. As a student at the Howard University College of Medicine, I found one of my mentors in Dr. LaSalle LaFall and another in Dr. Clive Callender. It would be many years later that I would meet Vernon Jordan, who took me under his wings as the others and invested the confidence for me to believe in myself. Howard Center for Sickle Cell Disease was another reason I chose to come to the university to study. Within the center, I found a caring team of doctors and nurses, a peer group who could talk to me about my sickle cell, a widely misunderstood and misdiagnosed disease at that time, and taught me how to live with it. While I was studying to become a physician, I never met any surgeons who had sickle cell disease, and I still haven't. Around the country, African-American doctors represent a very small minority in the medical field, far fewer than our percentage in the general population. And that remains true today, unfortunately. I had many compelling reasons to abandon my aspirations and settle for a life different than the one I wanted. I never gave up because my confidence never wavered. At Howard University, no one was able to tell me that I wasn't capable of doing something. My teachers, doctors, and peers told me again and again that there were no limits to what I could do. While my personal story might be an exception to the stories of those with sickle cell, it doesn't mean that I am personally exceptional. My success has everything to do with the environment I was fortunate enough to find, one where I was told that excellence was required of me so that I could be of greater service to my community. At Howard University, we encourage our students to pursue an interdisciplinary course of study. Of course, we want our students to develop technical expertise and to delve deeply into their chosen fields. But it is vital that they understand the social context in which their chosen fields operate. As a cancer surgeon, I have a responsibility to do more than just perform cancer operations. Yes, I need a thorough understanding of medicine and the latest surgical practices in order to provide the greatest care for my patients. But in truth, I cannot provide the greatest care for my patients if I focus exclusively on their diagnoses and ignore the social determinants that contributed to their conditions. My patients are predominantly black and brown individuals who live in underserved parts of Washington, D.C. Even within such a wealthy and well-off city, communities of color experience rampant inequities within the healthcare system. So much of what they need to lead healthy lives is difficult for them to obtain. They have less access to healthcare providers. They have less access to healthy foods. During the pandemic, they had limited opportunities to adequately protect themselves from the coronavirus, both at work and at home. So my duty as a cancer surgeon is to promote solutions to healthcare inequities, just as much as it is to perform surgery. Both functions are essential to caring for my patients. You who are graduating today must take a similarly expansive perspective of your roles, whatever your course of study and chosen specialty. Equipped with the degrees you are receiving, there are many paths you may choose to pursue. You may make a living in a laboratory or an operating room, in the classrooms of academia or the boardrooms of corporations. Wherever your path may lead you, it is important that that path be wide and winding rather than straight and narrow. When I came to Howard initially, I wanted to find a cure for sickle cell, and I felt incredibly fortunate to have arrived at Howard in order to study medicine and also to receive treatment from Howard Center for Sickle Cell Disease. Howard changed the course of my life, but I knew that not everyone could come to Howard and be as fortunate as I had been. So I wanted to find a cure that would liberate sickle cell patients like me to pursue their dreams. But as it turned out, my path went in a different direction. I became a cancer surgeon and a university administrator. While I did not impact my community and my world in the way that I imagined directly, I would as a young student, I never turned my focus away from having an impact. I knew that I had to try and make a difference. And how I managed to do so was less important. So do not focus so intently on your work that you fail to see its significance. Do not focus so intently on your work that you ignore or disregard or fail to hear the public conversation surrounding it. Do not focus so intently on your work that you forget what drove you to conduct it in the first place. Of course, you need to be passionate about what you do. And according to the wise words of the great poet Maya Angelou, you can only become accomplished at something you love. Don't make money your goal. Instead, pursue the things you love doing, and then do them so well that people can't take their eyes off of you. It is good to be passionate about your work, vital even, but I want you to be equally passionate about its purpose. While you are all passionate students about your particular subjects, I hope that you also become equally ardent students of the world. Because with the power of your education at your disposal, you have the capacity to change it. Today, graduates, is a day to not only recognize the responsibility you have, but to understand it. It is a responsibility that I work to convey to my students at Howard University and that I am expected to impart to you as well. Because in many ways, that responsibility is similar and it's shared. Your institution, the College of Science, Technology, and Applied Arts of Trinidad and Tobago, was created by an Act of Parliament in 2000. Howard was also founded by an act of government when our charter was signed into law by the President of the United States in 1867. Howard came into existence just 2 short years after the American Civil War ended. Our university was created out of a very real need to educate the freed slaves moving from the South to the North and empower black people with knowledge and skills to participate more fully in American society and the national economy. But Howard has always been focused on being much more than just that. Our charter specified that Howard was going to be a university from the very beginning, not a seminary or college, but a full-fledged university with multiple colleges and numerous disciplines. Within a year of the charter signing, Howard even created a medical school. Clearly, Howard was intended to be a place where students could come to get an education, not just a degree, to go out into society and act in accordance with the standards of Howard University. It was important that our students gained more than just technical expertise. They needed to be awakened to their mission in life and charged with the knowledge to pursue their purpose. As a federally chartered university, our students have a responsibility to live up to that institutional mission. And as students who have benefited from an act of parliament, you share in that mission. Your government has entrusted its resources in you. Your country, your community, your fellow Trinidadians and Toboganians have invested in you. As the president of Howard, I'm working to repay a tremendous debt, a debt to the university that took me in, that trained me, that believed in me, a debt to a community that has reared me and empowered me, a debt to a country, imperfect though it may be, that has embraced me and given me an opportunity. We all have incurred debt for the opportunities we have received, and upon receipt of your diploma, now is the moment that you begin to repay them. In Trinidad and Tobago, across America and throughout the world, we must take advantage of that transformational moment in global history to generate greater equity and justice. In the post-pandemic world, this is arguably our greatest and most important mission, because it is not enough to rebuild the world we had before. That world in many ways was imperfect, unjust, unequal, intolerant. It cannot be replicated, it must be improved. Today, graduates, I celebrate your achievement. This graduation is a reflection of the hard work that you have done the past few years to better yourselves and sharpen your minds. And I hope this milestone is yet another opportunity to reflect on your path forward and refocus on your life's mission. In a world such as ours, that is in a state of flux and in need of fixing, there's ample opportunity for you to shape it as you see it. As you move forward in your careers, may you remember the power of your education and as a force for social good, and your ability to influence the world around you when you embrace your full potential. Good luck and best of health to you all. Congratulations.
Because we believe that each graduate should be formally and publicly recognized on this day of celebration, the students' names will be read as their portrait and accomplishments are displayed on your screen.
Dr. Paul, on behalf of the faculty of COSTAATT, I am pleased to recommend that these candidates be granted the Bachelor of Science degree, the Bachelor of Arts degree, the Bachelor of Business Administration degree, the Associate of Applied Science degree, the Associate of Science degree, the Associate of Arts degree, the Advanced Diploma, and the Postgraduate Diploma.
Thank you, Dr. Edwards Henry. On the recommendation of the faculty and by virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of COSTAATT, I hereby confer upon you this afternoon the Bachelor of Science degree, the Bachelor of Arts degree, the Bachelor of Business Administration degree, the Associate of Applied Science degree, the Associate of Science degree, the Associate of Arts degree, the Advanced Diploma, the Postgraduate Diploma, with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereunto.
School of Business and Information Technologies, Department of Information Science and Technology, Adrian Bush, Malachi Alexis, Corrine Henry, Roxanne Rollocks, Chanel Farrell, Leah Francis, Jason Ramlal, Richard Karimbokas, Nicholas Dibb, Amos Paul, Brett Andrews, Isaiah Emmanuel, Lavon Haven Passad, Daniel Mason, Ruel Cato, Travon George, Christina Khan, Trayal McLeod, Chantel Sudin, Brent Thomas, Aaliyah Cato, Dane Dyer, Jamal Emmanuel, Akeem Khan, Maria Mendoza, Kyle Richardson, Rodrigo Sanchez, Renee Edwards, Samil Hutchins, Aisha Michelle Mew, Marissa Ryan, Jeanette Besson, Denise Charles, Nicholas Dionat, Daniel Danpat, Matthew Diffentala, Tamika Fleming, Kyle Herman, Fidel Joseph, Devon McNeil, Ishan Ramanan, Jason Ramjatan, Nigel Rodriguez, Dominic Silandi, Nalini Silochan, Department of Management and Entrepreneurship, Jamie Alexander O, Fallon Alexander Thomas, Azaria Balfour, Samantha Boudram, Vera Bupsing, Leah Chinalion, Gaylene Christmas, Suan Cipriani, Kanita Connell, Alana Domingo Cuffey, Melinda Guilford Clifford, Judy John Young, Claire LaChapelle, Veronica Marshall, Shalom McHutchinson, Michaela Mills, Sarah Mulchan, Janelle Ned, Eva Romero, Janelle Sugrim, Athalia Springer, Tashura Williams, Nadia Lively, Diana Matru, Lorraine Small James, Charisse Wharton, Josanne Winchester, Arlene Alexander, Kelly Ali, Suan Awang, Robert Bechan, Janelle Barber, Diana Bipath, Marika Bernard, Kimberly Boxill, Ikiel Braffitt, Melissa Campo, Prince Carrington, Tashana Clement, Tion David, Aura D'Souza, Melissa Despo, Dion Emmanuel, Leticia Glasgow, Charisse Gordon, Nalini Hiralau, Shalian Hope, Chanel Jadu, Khadija Jordan, Natalia Joseph, Christine Liverpool, Betty Mahabir, Shalini Mahadio, Vishal Maraj, Lanisha Moore, Lisa Narayan Singh, Laverne Nelson, Candace Nicholas Richardson, Nayoka Prince, Gemma Ramdeen, Xaviera Rampasad Singh, Mohini Ramraj, Samantha Ramratan, Karis Richardson, Liana Salazar, Lachman Samaru, Danique Spring, Joelle Tellisford, Tariq Thomas, Kanesha Vincent, Ronald Webb, Crystal Ali, Crystal Antoine, Samantha Arjun Singh, Colleen Barkley, Stacey Callender, Jolene Cox, Ayana Dindial, Emilia Fortu, Javia Garawi, Janelle Gilalta, Melissa Granger, Joy Greenwich, Nicolette Holden, Kerry Hussain, Leanne King, Mikado King, Kayomi Lake Davis, Jemima Leacock, Tamisha Laukau, Giselle Mark, Lennox McWilliams, Akita McKenzie, Radha Narayan Singh, Krisana Newsom, Carissa Pascal, Janelle Pale, Rishma Radu, Samantha Rampasad, Sharon Roberts, Abigail Taylor, Nigel Thomas, Kelly Marie Young, Marissa Antoine, Jody Archer Royal, Tanil Eugene, Desiree Felix, Stefan Francis, Kalisa Hostan, Nicole Joseph, Danielle Lamazou, Giselle Louison, Makita Mack, Nicole Pantaleon Kingston, Chantal Richardson, Stephanie Rochford, Chanel West, Antonio Agard, Liana Ali, Justine Augustus, Pramati Bajnath, Jabari Bannister, Alana Barkley, Ariana Budu, Ruth Bavel, Mark Braffitt, Isaiah Brown, Shellyanne Charles, Dre Cooper, Kenesia Cox, Crystal Cross, Lachelle Daniel, Renee Delea, Sabrina Dore, Dana Dixon, Neetu Dindial, Arlene Edwards, Kimberly Edwards, Stefan Edwards, Roland Flemings, Fidel Frederick, Christy George, Liana Gobin, Terry Gonzalez, Jonathan Gopi, Jacob Isava, Avanel John, Akini Joseph, Ophelia Joseph, Chanel Kennedy, Danica LaRoche, Petulia Lashley, Anya Lois, Tatiana Luchman Singh, Ayana Marshall, Christiane Maynard, Khadija McKnight, Kevin McLean, Salisha Mohammed, Alicia Mohammed Badri, Kevin Passad, Unavati Passad, Kishan Pear, Amy Raghu, Aaron Rajlal, Nichelle Ramjewan, Parvati Ramkisu, Zaria Ramsarup, Marian Ramsundar, Avella Raphael, Davinia Romaine, Rachel Samaru, Risha Scotland, Kamaria Scott, Jonathan Sukdeo, Adeline Thomas, Janelle Thomas, Nikisha Torres, Crystal Vieira Quashi, Cheyenne Williams, Kizan Wilson, Shivani Ramkaran, Christopher Sukumar, Candice Shade Cook, Wendell Mitchell, Karen Ali, Chloe Antoine De Silva, Kim Bartholomew, Lamoya Kane, Shania Chapman, Anne Clement, Renice Daniel, Mercedes Davis, Natalie Dennis, Matthew Dyer Mondesir, Stephanie Fraser, Akiba Glasgow, Tiffany Guevara, Brittany Huggins, Annette Irish Garibana, Renissa Kusial, Abigail Lalji, Afisha Lara, Priya Miraj, Ansel Morris, Renisha Prescott, Amila Rahman, Victoria Rambali, Crystal Rambaran, Tanesha Reynolds, Jamelia Ross Paul, Shivana Sinat Singh, Janella Wong, Kelson Gordon, Leah Chaitram, Shada Jennings, Akila Lewis, Avion Matthews, Nicolette Medford, Karen Roberts, Colleen Burton Singh, Stacey Ann Kajol Thomas, School of Nursing, Health and Environmental Sciences, Department of Environmental Studies, Kevon Henry, Lisa Sebastian, Jovette Vidal, Keisha Alves, Roseanne Bruce, Melissa Charles, Lindian Davis, Stephanie Dinchong Cox, Debian Harry, Rishi Ragby, Dylan Ramroop, Carlton Seaforth, Shelian James, Naseema Ramkar Singh, Alana Smith, Khadija Bedu, Kizzy Brown, Salisha Chedi, Sasha Garraway, Nikisha Hamilton Panton, Kumar Kemraj, Shireen August Alet, Nival Pasad, Kanisha Providence, Bharati So, Sharon Shim, Karen Yearwood, Department of Health Science Technology, Natalia Alcala Maharaj, Rachel Boudram, Tiffany Bunsey, Adej Charles, Jarell Dukan, Erin Gilbert, Donwati Hariprasad Sue Ramsubag, Luesta Lewis, Candice Maxima, Stephen Ramsuak, Rochelle Salvery, Candice Sibu, Kieran Sumai, Khadija Tanner, Shaquin Williams, Chanel Cave, Shivana Das, Tina Greenwich, Shanika McCain, Jamiel Panto, Brandon Pear, Rishma Ramsahai, Siddiqui Ross, Rayana Agarat, Susan Anastasio, Sharon Bahor, Jillian Dubois Chun, Tracy Garraway, Saskia Hall, Candice John, Priscia Joseph, Selena Khan, Karina Narine, Nirmala Ragbi Ramdath, Helen Ramutar, Amanda Subaru, Taffy Thomas, Abby Dover, Sindira Mohanlal, Reza Ramjas. Department of Natural and Life Science, Leah Bartholomew, Gothlin Blenman, Anishka Chunilal, Vas Dilchan, Rinelle McDonald, Allison Mohammed, Josanne Paul, Monique Pear, Diana Ramden, Renuka Ramtahal, Narendra Santoki, Nicholas Yishan, Ronika St. Hilaire, Beverly Bino Scrub, Jordana Hassanali, Aaron Joseph, Kimmy Lamott, Kimberly Redmond, Nikki Rivers, Nadia Singh, Christoph Winchester, Daniela Wolford. Department of Nursing, Darian Abdul Solomon, Dana Aberdeen, Katrina Ali, Samiha Ali, Samantha Ambrose, Nadine Anderson, Janelle Augustine, Denise Balkaran, Zakia Balthazar, Saron Banfield, Unika Bartholomew, Mohani Basdale, Kayla Battersby, Shanice Beckles, Lisa Bob, Veena Budai, Trinice Budramsing, Akisha Brown, Whitney Byam, Tamika Campbell Roberts, Liana Chablow, Naomi Chadburn Lawrence, Ahona Shalari Joseph, Kadisha Charles, Kareen Charles Phillip, Theresa Church, Renee Clark, Chelsea Cole, Natalie Commissiong Roberts, Erla Copeland, Rachel David, Jacqueline Deboulay Sami, Paula Dick, Sasha Dooney, Rosemary Douglas, Camille Dublin, Camelia Duke, Shalyan Dyer Chan, Jeanette Figuero, Lena Francois Biraz, Carla Friday, Tanisha Glasgow, Elizabeth Glodon, Gareth Gumansing, Nick Hamilton Mills, Khadija Hepson, Wenerlin Housand Adams, Josan John, Natasha John, Shanice John, Don Johnson, Chantel Johnson, Sherilyn Joseph, Nigel Joseph, Rona Josiah, Tracial Kadu, Natasha Kent, Janika Lalchan, Kimberly Leslie, Makita Logie, Antonia Madu, Stacian Mahabir, Sabina Makozi, Crystal Manrique, Melissa Martinez, Alni Matthews, Anissa Mears, Gabrielle Mears, Salisha McDougall, Samantha Mialal, Rachel Maloney, Michelle Metivier Lazama, Melissa Mohammed, Sasha Mohammed, Shaliza Mohammed Allah, Nandrani Motilal, Keisha Motilal Sandy, Katriona Mulrain, Karen Ningsu, Leona Noel, Rachel Noyan Mohan, Mahalia Orozco, Kachita Parchment, Tanisha Payne James, Rosalind Passard Lape, Tricia Phillip, Candice Phillips Cumberbatch, Carolina Punsami, Glodine Ragubar, Camille Ragunanan, Tracy Ragunath, Kate Rajkumar, Johanna Ramdas, Janil Ramdi, Leah Ramharak Kedar, Leah Ramkisu, Trisha Ramnath, Samantha Ramsaran, Brittany Ramsumir, Ravina Ratanlal, Keisha Lee Ravello, Charisse Remy, Vanessa Riley, Listra Roberts, Chanel Roberts Newton, Jenny Scott, Abigail Seachan, Patricia Simmons, Amrika Sinanon, Alana Singh, DeAndre Smith, Anicia Solomon, Shirlene Sukdale, Ayana Spencer, Demi Suchit, Jade Tang Funkuri, Karina Thomas, Kawain Thomas, Kathian Thomas, Kelly Wade, Alex Walkins, Anne Williams, Kamel Williams, Merrill Young, Crystal Alfred, Sherry Bristol, Letitia Cox, Jillian Cupid, Celeste Gaspard, Christine Graham, Candice Holder Abdul Hakim, Rhonda John, Shamil Mohammed, Julie Singh, Nicole Williams, Rhonda Charlotte, Allison Gibbs Mohammed, Michelle Glodon, Denise Joseph, Anne-Marie Pascal, Esther Sampson, Marlene Simon, Ayana Straker, Tamika Valdez.
Each year at the graduation ceremony, the COSTAATT Valedictorian Award is presented to the students who have attained the overall highest GPA at the associate degree and the bachelor's degree level. The valedictorian with the overall highest GPA in the college at the associate degree and bachelor's degree levels are selected as the 2020 class valedictorians, respectively.
Today, the award for the 2020 class valedictorian for the bachelor's degree and highest performance is presented to Desiree Felix, who earned a GPA of 3.913, having completed the Bachelor of Business Administration in Marketing from the School of Business and Information Technologies, Department of Management and Entrepreneurship.
And the award for the 2020 class valedictorian for the associate degree and highest performance is presented to Zoe Ledu, who earned a GPA of 3.921. Zoe completed the Associate of Arts degree in Spanish from the School of Liberal Arts and Human Services, the Department of Language, Literature, and Caribbean Studies.
We will now hear from Desiree Felix, the 2020 valedictorian for the bachelor degree level, who will deliver a message on behalf of her graduating class.
Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. I am humbled and grateful to be this year's valedictorian. It's something I never set out to become. I just wanted to give this race my best run and finish strong, and hopefully with summa cum laude. I entered COSTAATT in 2015, what now seems like a century ago, after my life partner nagged me and my friends encouraged me to give it a try. I immediately felt a bit ancient. There were so many people younger than me, and I was afraid that I wouldn't be able to keep up with them. As I say this, I am sure my classmates are shaking their heads in disbelief, but it's the truth. The last time I was in a classroom was back in 1995, when Moses was a little boy running through Egypt with his friends. While at COSTAATT, it probably looked like I had it down pat, but what most people saw was the end result and not the hard work it took to get here. I was like that proverbial duck, calm on the top, but paddling at 100 miles per hour below the water. Because believe it or not, I am dyslexic. I mix up my letters all the time, so I had to pay very close attention to every assignment. Exams took me twice as long because I had to first write in pencil, then write over in ink before the time was up. But I really wanted to do my best, which meant holding myself accountable for what I was supposed to learn. So I worked my tail off, and here I am today. Would you believe it if I told you that the grade I am most proud of from the past 5 years is my C+ in finite math? Yes, I have a C+ on my record, and I fought hard for that grade. Even though I had an excellent lecturer, thank you, Mr. Maynard, I just wasn't getting it. It was the most frustrating class because I was going to fail at something supposedly easy. Then slowly, I started to understand it just in time for the final exam. I went into it knowing that I had to pull off a miracle to pass. And when I saw that C+, it felt like an A+ and a lotto win. Talk about tears of joy. It was a victory that almost felt as good as I do today. I am certain that many of you have that one subject that you didn't get the best grade in, but it's one that you are very proud of. My fellow graduates, it would be entirely wrong to think that our achievement was done in isolation. None of us could have made it without a number of people. So to our families and friends, thank you. Thank you for the million small things you did to make our lives easier. We cannot express enough gratitude for you. We love you all. I specifically want to highlight my parents and my posse, Joanne Richards Dubois, Natasha Assey, Kelly Young, and Crystal Ali, for always being there when I needed help, day or night. Much love to my son, Officer Cadet Graham Felix of the Trinidad and Tobago Coast Guard, and my daughter, Caitlin Romani. You were a big part of my motivation to do well because I wanted to lead by example. And to my life partner, Erwin Romani, you encouraged me to start this journey and you stood by me every step of the way. Now, all of this is entirely your fault. Thanks a lot. To our alma mater, thank you for doing everything possible to help us along our academic journey, especially when life threw us curveballs, like with the COVID-19 madness that almost put a chokehold on our graduation plans. What this college has taught us is that we have the ability to overcome any obstacle in life, planned or unplanned, to accomplish our goals. Graduates, our achievement is testimony to our determination and courage to find a way to succeed by any means necessary. And to our lecturers, thank you for your dedication to our learning, for giving something of yourselves to us. I personally got some excellent pearls of wisdom from them, such as Mr. Richards' profound yet practical declaration in Intro to Psychology that we don't have to like each other, but we do have to work together, which totally changed the way I looked at group assignments. Or Mrs. Kasoon Week's wise advice that no one knows your work better than you do. So don't worry about the audience and just present your stuff. Advice I wish I had received early in my COSTAATT years. I especially want to thank Mrs. Santana for her guidance during our marketing senior practicum, and for her passionate attention to detail, which inspired me to use at least 4 grammar checkers, 3 citation generators, 2 plagiarism sites, and a partridge in a pear tree when doing assignments. Before I bid you farewell, let me leave you with some advice of my own. I have found that in life, sometimes the only way out is through. In spite of all the challenges, we have come through and out safely and successfully on the other side. Therefore, no matter what, stick to your goal, find your solution, and see it through. And now, my last golden nugget of wisdom for you. It's something from my deceased grandfather, Beke Seventu of Paramen, which I always try to follow. He used to say, in Trinidad, frog is not good to eat, but if you have to eat a frog, eat a big one. In other words, you're already doing it. You might as well go big. My fellow graduates, let us make the most of this moment. Appreciate the effort it took to achieve it and celebrate this awesome milestone in our lives. We've gotten this far on our journey, so let's continue the only way we know how, by continuing to go big. We are COSTAATT's graduating class of 2020, and I am so proud of us all. Congratulations, and thank you.
Now, graduates, we have come to a very special moment in this graduation ceremony and a well-established COSTAATT tradition that no virtual ceremony will stop: the graduates' serenade. The COSTAATT Performing Arts Jazz and Voice Ensemble will perform a very special serenade to honor you, the 2020 graduating class.
Rise on a friend, I'll rise up. we have each other. For that we have each other.
Thank you very much to the members of the COSTAATT Jazz Ensemble for that stirring and inspiring performance. We will now hear from the 2020 valedictorian for the associate degree level, Zoe Lelu.
Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. I am deeply honored and humbled to be speaking on behalf of the graduating class of the unforgettable year 2020, to express sincere gratitude to all those who have supported us on this journey. First and foremost, however, I thank God for making this all possible, for the blessings He bestows, for being my constant guide and source of strength, and for always making a way where there seems to be no way. I would not be here today without him. It has been a challenging year for us all, one that makes this graduation unlike any other. The whole world has changed drastically due to COVID-19, and we have all faced hardships as a result. Yet, education knows no bounds. And in the midst of this global pandemic, I am grateful that we are still able to come together, albeit virtually, to celebrate our academic accomplishments. Of course, no man is an island, and we could not have achieved any of this by ourselves. This idea was captured very eloquently by Mexican author Laura Esquivel in one of my courses during the associate degree. We had to analyze her famous novel, Como Agua para Chocolate, like water for chocolate. In it, she wrote, "Todos nacemos con una caja de fósforos en nuestro interior, pero no podemos encenderlos solos. Necesitamos la ayuda del oxígeno y una vela." In English, that means, each of us is born with a box of matches inside us, but we cannot light them alone. We need the help of oxygen and a candle. For each of us, our candle is whatever passion ignited that flame inside of us and lit our match. Whether it was music, science, art, languages, management, criminal justice, the desire to help others, or simply the love of learning and the quest for more knowledge. Our oxygen was the unfailing support of those around us who kept our flame burning. Our loved ones, our families, parents who put up with all our ranting and complaining, who encouraged us when we got low, reassured us that we could do whatever we put our minds to, and who made so many sacrifices so that we could succeed. Our lecturers, like Mrs. De Silva and Mrs. Guzman, each so special and unique in their own ways, who invested their time in us, who believed in us, who pushed us to reach our full potential. They inspired us to commit ourselves to a standard of excellence and to give our absolute best. There are no words in English or Spanish to express how much we appreciate and admire them. Our classmates, whose own flames danced beside ours throughout this journey, shared in our joys, triumphs, and challenges alike. We would commiserate with each other about all the deadlines and the essays and the stress. We would help calm each other's nerves before presentations. We worked together on group projects, combining our individual talents to create something that reflected our strength as a unit, even if things got a little bumpy in the process. We got to know each other along the way, as equals and as colleagues, and over time, that classroom acquaintance gave way to friendships forged through the passions that we shared. There are countless others, from the Board of Trustees, to the administration and library staff, to the security guards, to the ladies who run the snack stand, who all worked behind the scenes to keep our flames burning, whether they knew it or not. To all of these people, I say a heartfelt thank you. Thank you for being our oxygen. My fellow graduates, as we close this chapter of our lives and embark on another, there is no telling what the future may bring. That is what makes it so intriguing. Wherever life takes us, it will be an adventure. There will be obstacles that we will have to overcome. There will be tests of character to help us grow. But we still have more matches inside of us, waiting to be lit, more passions waiting to be discovered, and more people with whom to share our light. Perhaps we can even become the oxygen to someone else's fire. I would like to leave you with one last quote that is particularly special to me. Life is a mystery to be lived, not a problem to be solved. Here's to the class of 2020. We have proven that no matter what life throws at us, even a mysterious virus, a pandemic, we shone our lights even brighter, and we demonstrated the will to rise. May we always strive for excellence in this mystery that is life. Thank you.
Congratulations to the valedictorians who did their fellow graduates proud with those two stirring addresses, and also to the faculty and staff who would have worked tirelessly to prepare them for this moment, not just the speech, but their whole experience at COSTAATT, and what a wonderful example they are and a model for others to follow.
Good afternoon, everyone. Special greetings to the graduating class of 2020. All protocol observed. I am Patricia Thorne, clinical instructor on the COSTAATT nursing program. Today, I'm going to read you the nurse's pledge, and I wish you all the best in your undertaking. I solemnly pledge
myself before God and in the presence of this assembly to faithfully practice my profession of nursing.
I will do all in my power to make and maintain the highest standards and practices
of my profession. I will hold in confidence
all personal matters
committed to my keeping in the practice of my calling.
I will assist the physician in his work and will devote myself to the welfare of my patients,
my family, and my community.
I will constantly endeavor to increase my knowledge and skills in nursing and use them wisely.
I will zealously seek to nurse those who are ill,
wherever they may be and whenever they are in need.
I will be active in assisting others
in safeguarding and promoting the health
and happiness of mankind. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, and COSTAATT's newest graduates, we've come to the end of these graduation proceedings. And I now invite Dr. Naseem Koilas, Associate Vice President of Academic Affairs, to move the vote of thanks.
All previous protocols observe, a very good evening to all. British philosophical and inspirational writer James Allen wrote, "No duty is more urgent than of returning thanks, and it is indeed an honor to have been assigned the duty of giving the vote of thanks at this, our 2020 graduation ceremony. In all that we do, we must give thanks to Almighty God for guiding us through life's journey, and today's celebration of your accomplishments is no exception. To our graduating class, 2020, congratulations, and thank you for giving us this opportunity to celebrate your accomplishment with you and your loved ones. No one could have predicted the events of 2020 and the need for us to host our celebration of your accomplishments in this virtual environment. We thank you for your patience in anticipation of this day. It's long due. You would agree that you did not individually achieve this goal, and therefore you must give thanks to your support network, your parents, guardians, spouses, significant others, teammates, and your classmates, all those persons who stood by your side, propped you up, and cheered you on. Some even provided hot meals and held down the fort so that you could attend classes and group meetings. Your success was also shaped by your academic heads, numerous faculty members, academic advisors, admissions counselors, administrative staff, registry staff, student development staff, to name a few. All of these units and people collaborated to ensure that your COSTAATT experience was fulfilling and worthwhile. We must single out our faculty and acknowledge that not all superheroes have capes. Some have teaching degrees. In the words of John Wooden, I think the teaching profession contributes more to the future of society than any other single profession. As we celebrate your success today, we acknowledge our indebtedness to these individuals who supported you along this journey, and we extend heartfelt appreciation. Executing a graduation ceremony does not happen overnight, even in the virtual environment. Today's event would not have been possible without the hard work and unwavering support of many persons. As usual, the chairman and members of the Board of Trustees, we appreciate your wisdom, guidance, and dedication to COSTAATT. We remain grateful to our dear president, Dr. Jillian Paul, who during these challenging times remain dedicated to seeking the best interests of our students and staff. Our sincerest thanks to you for commitment and leadership and for successfully presiding over today's graduation ceremony, Dr. Paul. We offer our sincere thanks to Dr. Wayne Frederick, president of Howard University, for addressing our graduates and sharing his experiences and invaluable insights. Dr. Frederick, your illustrious career is a fitting example of two of our graduates that with dedication and hard work, the sky is indeed the limit. To make this ceremony a reality, the wheels started rolling months in advance. We are fortunate to be backed by a small team of dedicated and highly motivated colleagues who know their job and are result-oriented. To our management team, academic staff, faculty, student, support staff, the months behind the scenes planning and working towards ensuring a successful event have not gone unnoticed. Special mention must be made of the departmental chairs and program coordinators, Office of the Registrar, marketing, and other staff from across the college. We know that it was not business as usual, as the COVID-19 pandemic compelled us all to do things differently. We offer our sincere thanks to you for your willingness to take on the completion of tasks, even those that were beyond your comfort zone. We are very proud of our valedictorians, and we expect great things from you. You will always be part of the COSTAATT family, but now you, the entire graduating class of 2020, are also COSTAATT ambassadors. Represent and promote us well. We wish each graduate the very best. We are grateful that you shared this leg of journey with us. As you go forth in life and explore future endeavors, continue to be curious and keep learning. Whatever you may choose to do henceforth, do it with heart and passion. Strive to help your fellow humans to rise above their circumstances. Focus ahead on achieving your goals, but never forget your humble beginnings. Finally, always remember that you possess the will to rise. Congratulations and all the best. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Koilas. As thank you speeches go, that was quite comprehensive and very, very inspiring. We celebrate the more than 800 graduates of the 2020 graduating class as you join over 17,000 COSTAATT graduates who have gone before you. You join a very, very special force for transformation, not only in the Society of Trinidad and Tobago, but in the wider world. Congratulations to you and best wishes once again. I now invite Dr. Camille Samuel, Vice President of Student Affairs, to formally bring this afternoon ceremony to a close. Dr. Samuel.
Thank you very much, Dr. Paul. Well, my dear friends, we are now at what we consider the end of what was a fantastic ceremony. Don't you agree? It was fantastic. Congratulations to our 2020 graduates. Congratulations to all of you. And so, without further delay, ladies and gentlemen, graduates, I now hereby declare these 2020 graduation proceedings over. Thank you all for your attendance and your attention. I hope you have enjoyed our virtual ceremony as much as I have. Good evening.
Right here in the back, yeah, yeah. And we go sing a lick, sing a lick, sing a lick. It's a vibe, so we be singing, I am right here in the back, yeah, yeah. have a foot and a step. But every backyard must have an answer, someone who will keep the order to give you house rules and safety tips. So when you went bungalow, you won't break it. Please don't need no big promoter. Be neighbors, go be his sponsor. When you see the police, they're there, come get something to eat right here in the backyard. Yeah. And we go tingle-licka, tingle-licka, tingle-licka. It's red lights when we meet the night right here in the backyard. In your kitchen, grab a pot and then start beating.
But every yard must have a whiner, a hot girl to show off to bumper. Who will go down, start wine and bowl it like Alice Hines.
We don't need no big promoter, the neighbors go be the sponsor.
Hey,
when you see the police, tell them we're not mashing up the street, we hear it in back. Yeah, yeah. And we go ting-a-licka, ting-a-licka, ting-a-licka. It's a vibe when we beat it, I had right here in the back. Go straight in your kitchen, grab a pot and then start kitchen. Level, 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 level.
Hey, 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 hey. Section one, already, already, already. Good.
Ding, 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 ding.
Oh, ding, yeah.
Ding, ding, ding.
Section two, ding, section two.
Ding, ding,
oh, yeah.
Ding, 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 ding,
ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding, ding.
We go sing a licka, sing a licka, sing a licka. Israel vibes where we be dead.
Yeah,
yeah, go straight in your kitchen. Grab a pot and then start beating. Here in the back. Yeah, hey, hey, and we go sing a licka, sing a licka, sing a licka. Israel vibes where we be dead. I am right here in the back.
Yeah,
hey, jam. Go straight in your kitchen. Grab a pot and then start beating. Here in the back. Yeah, and we go.
Little,
little, little, little. Red vibes, let me be denied.
Yeah,
jam. Go straight in your kitchen. Grab a pot and take that kitchen. Don't stand up and don't fear.
Live your life like you're playing mine.